Greetings and welcome to an ASMR gaming video. Today I am playing Monster Hunter World, the new beta for the PlayStation 4. We're on the main menu here, and I guess I'm gonna try out the single player mode, so let's get started. I already had some fun with this game before, and let's see. Should we choose a male or female character? Honestly, in Monster Hunter, a lot of the end game level armor looks a lot cooler on the female characters for the most part compared to the male characters, so that's why I usually go with a female character. She looks cool, I guess. Change the background too. That's nice. Confirm. Enter name. ASMR Gaming News. Or you know what? Let's just call ourselves AGN. So, my history with Monster Hunter, I played the original PlayStation 2 game, I played the PSP games a lot, and I played some of the Wii and Wii U games, and other than that, I haven't played any of the new Monster Hunter games, you know, for the 3DS and all the other spin-offs and things, so it's been a few years since I've played Monster Hunter. But this one actually seems like it's going to be great, so I've already done this beginner and intermediate quest, but I think I might go, you know what, let's just do one of the first two, I guess. Let's do this one. We'll start with the easy quest first. So I'm going to change my equipment. It automatically gives you, like, the steel axe here, but I do not want to use a steel axe. I want to use, this right here, jaw blade. So, the great sword or jaw blade or basically this right here, this weapon, is what I've used for every single Monster Hunter game that I've ever played. I've always used this weapon. It's the one that I'm most comfortable with, so I guess I'm going to stick with that. And for him, I'm gonna go with the hammer. There we go. Depart. Okay. This is gonna be fun. So I guess I'll do the easy quest first, and then we'll go do the medium difficulty quest. So in Monster Hunter, basically, you hunt monsters. You start out at a camp right here. Oh, they have voice acting in this game. That's honestly kind of strange, considering Monster Hunter usually always had, like, gibberish speak, similar to Animal Crossing, where the characters in the game would never actually speak a real language. Okay. Yeah. I like how detailed the map is. The map looks really nice. They put a lot of effort into that. So, let's go. Okay, so, here we have the camp. Wow, this area is beautiful. honestly the best looking. Okay, cool. No, I don't want to eat a meal. So, in the real game, if you sit down and eat a meal before a hunt, it'll give you, like, buffs and stat boosts for elements and stuff like that before you go on your quest. Then there's, like, the supply box, which will usually give you, you know, stuff that's useful for your quest, but we don't need anything right now. So, let's get going and try to find this monster we're supposed to take out. Now, something that I noticed is there's, like, these fireflies that kind of tell you where you're supposed to be going. Most of the Monster Hunter games I've played never had this, so this feels like easy mode. You usually have to hunt for the monster, but in this, you can just follow these fireflies and pick up clues along the way that eventually pinpoint you in the correct direction of where the monster is. Just take a look at this area. Looks very nice. Monster Hunter is kind of infamous for having very bad graphics. Well, traditionally, like on the PSP and stuff, a lot of the fans would complain that each game looks exactly the same. So it's nice to see Capcom actually put money in and try to make this game look a lot better than all the previous ones. Okay, so I guess I'm supposed to be, like, collecting all these footprints and stuff, but I'm just gonna keep following these fireflies, and it's bound to lead us to where we're supposed to go soon. Yeah, down here. Here we go. So, focus camera, so that's who we're supposed to attack. So let's go sneak up behind him and attack this guy. Now I'm gonna show you how to properly play Monster Hunter, even though I'm quite rusty. Wow, didn't even attack him. Okay, so right there, I put my weapon away. You're always supposed to do that after you attack. You attack, roll, put your weapon, and then you run away. Why? Well, the reason for that is, if you keep your weapon out, you move a lot slower, and the enemy can quickly come and try to attack you. So what you want to do is go in for the attack, maybe two attacks, and then quickly roll and sheath your weapon and then attack again. And there's actually different stances and, like, button combos that you can do attacks with. I'll show you right now. So we have to evade this guy. He's trying to hit us because he's really angry. So, this right here is normal triangle, this right here is circle, and if you do them both at the same time, you'll do, like, an upward slash. So, you can use triangle, circle, or both at the same time, and if you hold triangle down, you'll actually charge this attack. This is only for the greatsword and a few other weapons, but basically, the longer you hold it, you charge up, and you do more damage. Now, this is only for certain weapons, and you really shouldn't be using it unless you're sure you'll be able to land the hit, because a lot of times, most monsters are extremely fast, and they can hurt you before you get the chance to attack. Wow, got him perfectly right there in the head. Great attack. So, you always want to roll to evade. And now he's starting to run away. We should hit him with... I don't think I can hit him. actually see it. So usually there's a way to throw something like a paintball at your enemies so then you know where they've run off to. But in this case, I guess we don't need it. We just need to follow these fireflies. Like I said, this is a very easy mode. Don't expect this in, like, the harder missions in the full game, because I doubt they're going to be holding your hand like this. So he's sleeping here and recovering, so we're going to charge this up, max, hit him right there in the head. Let's see if we can do another one. Nope, move beside. Ooh, and this is dangerous because all these other ones start coming out and trying to help him out. What? Oh, there we go. Defeated. And I took minimum damage, so that's great. And right after this, you sheath your weapon. You get on top, and you just carve. And what you want to do with this basically is, by carving up, you can do it like multiple times, usually like 3 times for the large enemies, and they give you like rare drops, like gems, certain parts of the monster that you can then use to craft stronger armor. And for the end game of the original like Monster Hunter games, it becomes insane because it basically has you go on repetitive missions where you have to keep fighting the same monsters over and over again in order to basically get a rare drop item in order to customize your armor and continue on harder quests. So that's something that I hope they fix for this version, because I'm not really a fan of fighting the same monster over and over just to upgrade my armor, because the drop rate is so, so rare. So let's head back in. No, we don't want to re-edit. We'll use the same one. Let's do the intermediate quest. Yeah, same stuff. So this should be fun. Probably hold the controller closer to the microphone this time. Here, just a second. Okay, so here we are on the second quest. We have to open our map again, and we have to go search for this monster. It's in that location. Or there's going to be clues there. So just like last time, we have to go look for clues. And let's just look at our items. So we have a mega potion, a normal potion, max potion, antidote, null berry, well done steak, raw meat, shock trap, poison knife, paralysis knife. Wow, they really give you whetstone. This is when your weapon becomes dull. You should always sharpen it, especially if you're hitting like blunt surfaces. So yeah, they give you basically everything that you need here. Let's use the barbecue split here. Oh, I'm totally not gonna get this right. You have to pull it up as soon as the song ends, and I'm too late. Nope, burnt me. So basically, how this minigame works is the barbecue spit, there's like a small song that plays, and you have to pull up the meat before the song finishes, and you'll get a well-done steak. And if you eat a well-done steak, it like boosts. It's kind of like eating meat or food before going in your hunt. It doesn't exactly give you like status boost and other like effects, but it does kind of benefit you in giving you like more stamina and health and stuff like that. So that's really nice. We didn't need it, but that's basically what it does. Let's go out here, I guess. And we'll follow the fireflies again and collect information. Just looking at the game, it's so beautiful. This really does look nice. Old footprints. Oh, we don't need an herb. More footprints. They continue over here. Another footprint. Where else? Old footprint. So yeah, this game is pretty cool. Especially to play with friends, like this game is actually online and you can play the beta online as well. And going on these hunts with your friends is a lot more enjoyable than doing them by yourself. So that's always really exciting. That's probably the best part of these games. I'll show you right here what happens if you just attack and then you try to sheath your weapon. See, it takes a longer time. But instead, if you do this, wait, I'll show you. If you attack, then roll, and then you sheath your weapon, you can get away a lot faster after you attack. So that's the ideal thing to do. We just just destroyed that. It's crazy. Destructible environments. Come on, let's keep attacking. Go, go. Yes. Oh, look. We broke off his tail. Now, that's actually rare sometimes, and you want to steal items and things that way. Many times, if you destroy parts of a monster, like a tail or a beak, they're actually rare items that you can use then to make parts of your armor. And while I was doing that, he came up behind me and attacked me. But, yeah, you can only do it once. So, at least I got the item or whatever. When you defeat him, you can carve him up 3 times. Whereas, if you cut off a piece of his body, you only get to carve that up once. And sometimes you get a rare drop for something, like a gem or something like that. And sometimes you don't. And I'm doing pretty badly here. Notice my stamina meter is decreasing as I run. That's actually how it is in the old games. When you run, your stamina decreases. So that's kind of annoying, but it's kind of like Dark Souls in a sense, where in Dark Souls you only have a certain number of attacks you can do before your stamina runs out. Uh-oh, we can't let him get over here. Starting to run off again, so now he's really injured. Notice how he's hobbling around. So come on, let's follow him. Whoa, there seems to be some deadly fish down there. Wow, this area looks really nice. And let's start attacking. Damage on the tail right now. So that's great. Let's do that again. monster usually has a weak spot that you just have to keep exploiting over and over again. Wow. And each monster's weak spot is unique. And sometimes, like right now, two monsters will actually start fighting each other. And sometimes that's a good thing because they help you defeat the monster that you are already fighting. And they drop rare items and things like right now. Let's see what these are. Tears or... Let's see. Slinger Thorn. Slinger Thorn. Parath Material. I don't know what that is, but... Where did he go? Where did he go? Did we lose him? No, he's over here. Okay, I was gonna say, like, where did he go? Stamina ran out. We have to do this soon. Let me eat some meat. Well done, steak. I should probably use the whetstone to sharpen my blade a second. Doing this sharpens it, so the sharpness is at the maximum, so you do more damage. Up there. Well, let's go up there too. Not sure exactly how you're supposed to attack. Wow, okay. You don't do that much damage. That is actually a new feature that I think they've introduced into the 3DS games. That wasn't something that you could do in the PSP versions of Monster Hunter, like ride on top of the monsters. And here we almost have them. Come on, come on. No. Let's go. He's almost dead. We only have like 5 minutes left before this ends. I'm gonna try to defeat him before this is over. Come on, come on, let's run, let's run. We got time left, 5 minutes. We're gonna defeat this guy. Wow. You're facing. It's not that kind of game. I think there were ways to do that at one point. Come on. Why does he keep running away? That's something so annoying. Against the clock. The first time I did this, I did a lot better than I am now. Now he's like restored his shell or whatever. There's like some crazy monster over there now too. No, 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 no. Wow. Digging this. Wow, I'm doing terrible. Where did he go? Such a pain because there's these two guys fighting at the same time. Come on, we almost got it. We almost got it. You know, his HP is like extremely low right now. Like I'm not even getting the chance to attack properly. Wow, when he hit me head on. I look like someone that hasn't ever played this game before. Come on. Get back here. Why does he keep running away? Ugh. Probably should have brought some other weapon. Seconds left or something. So, we finally managed to do it. So let's carve them up. And we should be getting some really nice things. Barret's shell. Tail. And see all this material you use to craft armor and gear and stuff like that. So there we go. Two quests completed, and that's Monster Hunter World. The beta is really nice, and I took a very long time beating this quest, over 20 minutes. That is not the normal time to beat a quest like this. So that just shows that I'm out of practice, but I hope you guys enjoyed this ASMR game video. Please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at ASMR Gaming News, and yeah, thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time.